So this is the procedure and formula for preparation of paracetamol tablet. So we are taking paracetamol as a drug, lactose as a diluent, and dry starch as a binder. Because we are going for the direct compression method, that's why we are taking dry starch as a binder and disintegrant. After that, we are taking talc as a glidant, magnesium stearate as a lubricant. So these are the quantities for one tablet: paracetamol 125 mg, lactose 375 mg, starch 48 mg, talc 40 mg, and magnesium stearate 12 mg. So procedure is that first we are taking 5% starch as a binding agent. Okay, the tablet was granulated using weight granulation method as follows. That means paracetamol. That means we are taking. We are not following the weight granulation method. We are going for the dry granulation method. Okay, we are just mixing all the ingredients. That means paracetamol, lactose, and dry starch and talc. We are already mixed properly. After that mixing and after that proper. That means sieving and that means after milling, after proper milling and sieving. When we are going for the uniform size of the granules, when we get the uniform size of the granules, after that we are going for the lubrication. That means we are blending process. We are adding magnesium stearate as a blender. Okay. So next come to the after preparation of the tablet, we are going for the evaluation of tablets. Okay. So first evaluation of tablet is hardness test. The tablet. The hardness of the tablet is characterized by Monsanto hardness tester. I have shown in the video that how we can calculate the hardness through Monsanto hardness tester. Next come to the weight variation test. So how do we calculate the weight variation test? First, we are randomly taking 20 tablets, okay? We have weighed the 20 tablets individually. After that, we are calculating the average weight of the tablet. Okay. So that average weight plus minus 10% is the weight variation test. If all the tablets undercomes in the plus minus 10% of the average weight, then we can accept the tablet weight. Otherwise, if it is differs from the plus minus 10%, then we can reject the particular tablet. So this is the process for the weight variation test. Next, come to the friability test. For the friability test, I have already demonstrated how can we determine the friability test. We are taking the rotary friability as a friability tester machine. Okay, so we are taking 10 tablets. First, we are weight all the tablets. Okay, and we are noted the tablets weight. After that, we are putting the tablets in the rotary friability for the 25 rpm for that is 5 minutes. Okay, so after that we are just after 5 minutes we are just again take the tablets and going for the weight. When after that we are just weight the tablets again. So already we had weighted the initial weight before, that means friability. And after friability, what is the weight of the tablet? We are again noted. So percentage of friability, we are just calculated 1 minus loss in weight divided by initial weight into 100. So loss in weight, how can we got the loss in weight? That means initial weight minus final weight is we are calculating loss in weight. Okay. So loss in weight, if the particular initial total tablet weight is, if it is approximately, if you are calculated for 150 mg, then if 10 tablets are there, then that means it is 1500 mg. After friability, if it is 1460, then loss of weight is 1500 minus 1460, it is 40 mg. So 40 mg divided by initial weight, that is 1500 mg into 100. According to this process, we can calculate the friability. Next, assay of the tablet. Okay, what is the process for the assay of the tablet? So 20 tablets are powdered and weighted. at quantity of the powder equivalent about 0.15 mg or paracetamol are accurately weighted and added 50 ml of 1 molar sodium hydroxide diluted with 100 ml of water and shake for 15 minutes. So in a round bottom flux, we are taking the 0.15 gram of paracetamol tablet, and we are taking media as a 15 ml of 0.1 molar sodium hydroxide and diluted with 100 ml of water in a strict of 15 minutes and add sufficient water to produce 250 ml. So first we are taking 250 ml round bottom flux, then we are adding the paracetamol tablet, okay, powdered paracetamol tablet, and we are adding solution as a sodium hydroxide 100 ml, and we are make up to volume up to 250 ml with water. Okay, after that they are mixed and filtered and diluted 10 ml with the filtrate to 100 ml with water. So we have to go for the filtration. After filtration, then we are diluted with water. Okay, so after dilution, we are again added 100 ml of 0.1 molar sodium hydroxide, and absorbance of the resulting solution at maximum, that means the lambda max about 257 nanometer. Okay, so after dilution, we are taking the sample for the absorbance in UV visible spectrophotometer at the, that is 257 nm. That is lambda max. Okay, so in 257 nm lambda max, we are using UV visible spectrophotoscopy and we are getting the absorbance. Okay, by this process we are calculating the assay. Next, disintegration study. So I have already demonstrate high pain will determine the disintegration study in the video. Okay, so for the disintegration test, we are taking medium as a water. Okay, and the speed of the disintegration apparatus is 30 cycles per minute and temperature should be 37 degrees Celsius. Okay, so this is the main condition for disintegration test. Okay, so in the disintegration test apparatus, I have shown that is 6 chambers are there. Each and every chamber, we have to put one tablet. Okay, so after putting the tablet, we just start the disintegration apparatus and we calculate the time. At what time the tablet become disappear is the disintegration time. Okay, one tablet was added into each of the 6 tubes of the apparatus and assembly was suspended in the beaker containing water, and time required to disintegrate each tablet was noted. Okay, so the for each and every tablet, total, that means tablet become disappear, that is called the disintegration time. Next, come to the dissolution study. So for the dissolution study, is carried out by using that is a USP type 2 apparatus. Okay, we are using USP type 2 apparatus for dissolution study. We are taking the set of condition was, I have already shown in the, that means video, how can we perform the dissolution study. Okay, so that is 6 chambers are there, that the volume of the chambers are 900 ml. We are taking 900 ml of 6.8 phosphate buffer and we are using paddle type, that is USP apparatus. Okay, paddle type USP apparatus, that is 2 type of dissolution study apparatus are there. One is paddle type and another one is basket type. Okay, so the rotation of the pedal is 50 rpm and we have to maintain the total sink condition, that is 37 degrees Celsius. Okay, we are taking 40 samples for 45 minutes. Okay, so 5 ml of samples were withdrawn at a time interval of 5, 15, 30, 45 minutes. Okay, each and every 15 minutes of time we had withdrawn 5 ml of sample, and we again maintained the volume of 900 ml by adding 6.8 phosphate buffer with that particular chamber. Okay, we after taking the sample of 5 ml, again we have to put the 6.8 phosphate buffer in that particular 900 ml beaker to make up the volume 900 ml. Okay. So after taking the sample, we diluted it properly, and we are taking the absorbance at 249 nanometer, that is wavelength, in UV visible spectrophotoscopy. Okay. After preparing the calibration curve, okay, so amount of drug release can be determined by given formula already given, and that is amount of drug release is equal to concentration into volume of dissolution medium into dilution factor divided by 1000. Okay, that is how can you calculate, that is the formula for amount of drug release, and percentage of drug release is amount of drug release divided by strength into 100. By this process only we can go for the evaluation of tablets. So this is the main evaluation parts of the paracetamol tablets.
We are going to discuss one of the most important evaluation study of tablet, that is hardness test. Okay, so you have seen this apparatus, this is called Monsanto hardness tester. Okay, here we have in this portion we have put one tablet on there, and we have to check from the scale whether it is actually situated here. From the beginning we are taking as a zero, and we just start to rotate this portion. After that you can just observe the tablet, where at what portion the tablet becomes break. Okay, you can see I have just scrolled it in upward portion. Okay, you can see the tablet is already broken. Now it is start from 5, now it is up to 7. So we just calculate this 5 as a 0, and up to 7 we can calculate the total hardness of the tablet. It is total 7, okay? It is total 6. You can see the hardness of that particular tablet is 6. By this process we can calculate the hardness of the tablet. So students, for evaluation of tablet, one of the most important evaluation test is friability test. So this one is the, this is called as a rotary friabilator. Here you have seen this machine, from along with this machine, with the help of this machine, we can calculate the friability test. So first I have taken 10 tablets, I have first weighted all tablets, and I have put it down in my book. Okay, and I just put it here, and I just adjust it. You can see all the tablets are going inside this machine. This is called rotary friabilator. I have already set the RPM, that is rotation per minute, already 100 RPM I have already set, and I just operate this machine for 10 minutes. Okay, after 10 minutes it will be continue to 10 minutes. After 10 minutes when it is completed, I have again calculate the weight of the final tablets. Okay, if the variation occurs, if the first we have taken the first 10 tablets weight, after 5 minutes, after 10 minutes rotation, we have again going to take the weight of the tablet. If any variation occurs, then we can conclude that the friability test. So students, this is the disintegrating test, okay, we have to go into perform. So you have seen this is disintegration test apparatus. Okay, so this is also one of the important method for evaluation of tablets. We have seen in two buckets are there. Okay, we have insert five tablets in each bucket. Okay, five tablets in each bucket. After that, we have set the timer. Okay, then we have to see in what time all the tablets become disappeared here. Okay, we have to calculate the time. By calculating the time, we can conclude that the disintegration time of that particular tablet. Here you have seen all the tablets are under the solution. Already solution is given here, solution media. From that media and from that time, we can calculate the disintegration time. So this is the dissolution apparatus we have seen. This is the, there are two types of dissolution apparatus are there. One is the paddle type and another one is the basket type. But here we are taking that the paddle type dissolution apparatus. Here you have seen the four chambers are there, and in this particular chamber we have taken the media, that is 6.8 phosphate buffer, for that particular sustained release tablet. Now here lifting down, we are going to start the dissolution apparatus. Here I have taken two tablets of sustained release tablets, that is the different brand. Okay, the composition is same but brand is different. Here we put the two different tablets here. Okay, we have put two different tablets here. Now we are going to start dissolution for 6 hours, and we have to collect the sample for that particular dissolution in half an hour interval of time. Okay, half an hour interval of time we have taken the sample, and after that we are going for the further study. After collecting the sample, we are take the sample for the UV analysis, and after that absorption are recorded. For this type only we can start the paddle type. Here I have started the paddle type. So for this dissolution process, we have to maintain the temperature of this apparatus, this media, for 37 degrees Celsius. Okay, after that, after 6 hours, we have to stop that, and every half an hour interval we have to collect the sample for the UV analysis. Now I'm just going to demonstrate the UV visible spectrophotometer. That is the main part of the maximum your, that means practical work. You have to calculate the absorbance here only. Okay, so this is Shimadzu UV visible spectrophotometer. Okay, so already you have seen the display of this particular UV visible spectrophotometer. Here different portions are there, that is you can calculate photometric spectrum, quantization, then kinetics, everything is already here. But you just go, what you have want, you just go for the calculation. Okay, here you have seen I have taken the near about 5 to 6 samples of total 6 samples already. They are diluted. Okay, proper dilution is there, and you have seen this is called cubate. Okay, this is called cubate. To all here you have seen 4 portions are there. 2 portions are already transparent and another 2 portions are non-transparent. Okay, I have to just put the samples, I have already put the particular samples in the cubate. Okay, and I have to, this is the opener of the UV visible spectrophotometer. You can see that is 2 portions are there. Okay, I have to put the 2 samples on here. First before putting the samples, first I have to calibrate with the particular instrument with the standard. Okay, first I have to calibrate with the standard, then after that I have to put the samples. Here you can see the that is non-transparent portion, I have to put like this way only. Okay, because the UV rays come through the that is transparent portion. The UV rays come through the transparent portion. So I have already put two samples here. One is standard, another one is sample. Okay. So by this process, now I am just describe you, by this process only I have to calibrate, I have to calculate the absorbance. Here already software is there, okay, that is UV probe software already installed in our computer along with this spectrophotometer. With the help of this software, we can calculate the absorbance. So this is the main portion of the UV visible spectrophotometer. You can calculate the absorbance also from this UV visible spectrophotometer.